In this video, I'll show you an Arduino sketch that can be used to control four gates on 1 to 3 tracks using only an Arduino Nano. I'll show you it operating in a code simulation program and then a mock-up. This video shows four gates on 3 tracks. You can use it with 2 gates if you wish. You may add a bell. I'll cover that in the rest of the video. This video is part of our Using Arduino for Fun series. I'm not going to bore you showing you how to code Arduino. The sketch is plug and play. I'll show you how to make changes if you wish. Use it on 1, 2, or 3 tracks and to add the bell. So what we'll do now is we'll take a look at a code and we'll show you what can be done with that code to modify the sketch very easily. The code has towards the bottom of a table a section for the number of sensors. You choose the number of tracks at this point. I am using 6 sensors for 3 tracks, and then I indicate what the sensor pin numbers are below. For 1 track, you'd have 2 sensors, 2 tracks, 4 sensors. Up to the top, we can change the gate speed, the speed at which the lights blink, the delay between the lights starting to blink and the gates closing, and then the circuit takes its time in deciding whether the train has left the intersection. This compensates for any miscues by your sensor. You can set that delay time, and then you can set the open and close angles on each of the gates that you have. This is a circuit board that we'll be using. The complete wiring diagram is linked below to go to our website. But a quick explanation, it uses only a Nano. There are provisions for input from the IR sensors, output to the servo motors for the gates, and then outputs to the blinking lights. You can choose the number of blinking lights, and you can add flashing lights to the gates. Now let's look at this thing in a code simulator. This has only 2 servos on there. You'll see it. The slide switches are replacements for the IR sensors. The simulator doesn't have IR sensors. I have 2 flashing lights up there, 2 servos, 1 for the entrance, 1 for the exit. What I will do is go high on these switches back and forth to show what it's like to bring a train into the intersection. When you're in full screen, note the bottom of the screen, you'll see what's happening in that intersection. Note also, 1 gate closes. The entrance gate to the track area closes, and then there's a delay, and it gives time for cars or trucks to clear the intersection, and then the gate on the opposite side of the track closes. Now, when we open, we do the same thing. When the train leaves, the exit gate opens first, and then the entry gate opens. Again, that stops some hot dog from going through that site, and notice that happening now. The exit gate is opening, then the entry gate will open. It stops some hot dog from going through there and running into the exit gate. Now, this will keep the gates closed and lights blinking as long as there is one train, at least one train in that crossing area. You can have 1 in there, 2 in there, 3 area in there. It's an extremely sophisticated system. It's really a lot of fun to play with, as you run trains in and out. Now remember, there's a 20-second delay so that when one train leaves, the gates don't open for at least 20 seconds. That way it compensates for any missed detections of cars. But it also gives you 20 seconds to have another train come back into that intersection. And if that happens, the gates stay closed. I think you get the picture on what's going on here. Now let's go ahead and we'll go over and we'll show you what it looks like in real life, in a mock-up. There are four servos here representing the entrance and exit area of the gates crossing the track. There are six sensors. There are two sensors per track, one on the entry, one on the exit. And the gates will operate based on my wooden fork exposure over the top of the sensor. When I put the fork over the top, it's the same as a train going in. Now you can't see it in this particular view of what's going on, but I'll change the view and you'll see the gates operate. It's exactly the same as it worked in the simulator. And the gates just operate as you go. Now this is a closer look so you can see the operation of the servos. Remember, you can change that gate speed, you can change the delays, but you'll notice that one gate opens and then the second gate opens after the first gate is fully open. There we close one, we close the second one. The code for this is below. If you need any help with it, let me know. I'm here, and I hope you enjoyed it. Would appreciate it if you subscribe and give me a like. Again, questions, use the comments box below.